Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters. Psalm 32:7 says, "The Lord is a hiding place for us. He preserves us from trouble. Indeed, the Lord is our refuge. He is our fortress. The Lord is our deliverer. He is our hiding place." Let us come into His presence as we worship Him with this song.
Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters. Let's sign ourselves. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. A warm welcome to each one of us to this series on the Beatitudes. Today we shall reflect on the first Beatitude taken from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 3, where our Lord says, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven." Prior to this, our Lord had already begun His ministry of preaching in the synagogues, healing the people, delivering them. Later, He goes on to choose His disciples. And as the people start following Him, He gives them this first sermon on the mount. These Beatitudes, brothers and sisters, are guidelines given to us by the Lord. Remember, the Lord's main mission is to establish the kingdom of heaven here on earth. And so He wanted us to know these guidelines by which the world would recognize. Now we would wonder, why would the Lord give us these Beatitudes to follow? We shall see in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7, verse 6, where it is written, "You are a people chosen by God. You are holy and consecrated. You are chosen among all the peoples of this world, and you are a treasured possession." Remember, we are God's treasured possession. God is still looking out for men and women with humble and contrite hearts. We see this in Isaiah 66, verse 2, Bahasis, all these things I have made. All these things are mine. But I will look for a heart which is humble and contrite in spirit, and one who trembles at my word. God is still looking out for men and women with humble hearts. He wants us to be salt and light of this world. As is spoken in Matthew chapter 5, verses 13 to 16, He wants us to shine as lights in this world. Only then will the world know whom we worship. Saint Augustine tells us, he teaches us that a poor man who is poor in spirit is the one who is humble and God-fearing. And he contrasts this with a man who is proud. He says, a person who is proud seeks after the kingdoms of this earth, whereas a person who is humble seeks after the kingdom of God. Humility, brothers and sisters, is the other side of the coin of love. Surely, we worship or believe in a God who is nothing but love. We see this in 1 John 4:20, verse 26, where St. John tells us that we know and we believe in the love of God because God is love. And he further goes on to tell us, whoever abides in love abides in God, and God abides in him. Being poor in spirit is a process, brothers and sisters. It doesn't come easily. It is carrying our cross daily, as you see in Matthew 16:24. Where the Lord tells us, if anyone wants to follow me, he shall deny himself and carry his cross daily and follow me. Brothers and sisters, we all know that the cross has two beams. One is the vertical beam and one is the horizontal beam. In the vertical beam, we see that the Lord allows trials and temptations in our lives so that we can fight them and become more and more like Jesus. In the horizontal beam, we have difficulties and trials coming through different sources. And these things, my brothers and sisters, if we carry them faithfully, then we shall surely be poor in spirit. And we are not alone when we walk carrying this cross. Our Lord is there with us. Let us see for some examples in the Bible. In the Old Testament, we have Moses in the book of Exodus. Sorry. We see how God calls him, and Moses is a very humble person. He also carries a cross, so to say. He hears the message from God and he has the responsibility of going and putting it before Pharaoh. And later the difficulties of the people, of grumbling, of complaining, the burden that he carries. And yet in all this, Moses keeps in close contact with God. We see Joseph. Joseph, my dear brothers and sisters, goes through a hard time for 13 years. And then he comes to the place where God wants him to be. He becomes a humble person. He reconciles with his brothers and sisters. In the New Testament, we see our Mother Mary, who is a model of humility. And God chooses her to be a mode of salvation for all of us. She assisted Jesus in our salvation. We have Saint Paul, brothers and sisters, who was also very humble. We see this in Philippians chapter 2, verse 3, where Saint Paul tells us, do not do anything out of conceit for God gives grace to the humble. But and he says that count yourself better, count yourself lower than the others, or rather count others better than yourself. Brothers and sisters, one thing was common in all of them, that they were all worshippers. And whatever difficulties they faced, they never gave up their relationship with the Lord. They worshipped God wholeheartedly. And therefore God used all of them to build His kingdom and to bring His kingdom here on earth, brothers and sisters. In a similar manner, you and I are used by God for His salvation. And God wants to use us. Let us be prepared so that God will use us. But prior to them, let us be prepared for a series of the difficulties that we face. A humble person understands when difficulties come and trials come. He or she knows that God is with him or her. And he chooses to cling to the Lord. James chapter 4 verse 6 tells us, God resists the proud but gives grace to the humble. The more we are humble, the more we find the presence of God in us. James 1 verse 22 tells us, for we should not be hearers but doers of the word. St. Paul reminds us in 2 Corinthians 5 verse 20, he goes on to tell us that God is reaching out through us and therefore we are ambassadors for Christ. Brothers and sisters, let's remember, each one of us is representing heaven. The minute we accept Jesus, we become citizens of heaven. And so here we are ambassadors of Christ. Let us never forget that we are ambassadors for Christ. Amen. God bless. And let us strive to be humble and imitate our Lord and Savior Jesus. God bless.
Comment below in the comment section and also share it with others. Don't forget to click the bell icon for notifications. Thank you and God bless.